Around Thanksgiving, when there is little to no brood left within the hive and the temperatures reach above 50 degrees, it's a good time to do your oxalic acid dribble. Oxalic acid is a naturally occurring acid within the hive already. We can use this to our advantage for a last varroa mite treatment before we lock up the hive for the winter months. Of course, all beekeepers would prefer not to treat their hives for varroa mites, but unfortunately, in our neck of the woods in central New Jersey, not treating is no longer an option. Our honeybees are in an evolutionary crisis and they need our help in order to survive. An oxalic acid dribble is very easy to make. We'll need to gather a few items: 600 milliliters warm water, 35 grams wood bleach, and 600 grams of sugar. First, we mix the water and the wood bleach to dissolve. Wood bleach is actually oxalic acid, and it's available at most hardware stores. Secondly, we will measure out 600 grams of table sugar, which is approximately 3 cups. We will stir in the table sugar and mix until it is completely dissolved and combined. When adding warm water, we want it to be warm enough that it will last until we take it outside to treat our bees, but not so warm that it's boiling and could risk burning them. So, per our directions, we now have our solution mixed. It is time to take it outside. Using an extra syringe to administer children's medication, or a syringe that you've ordered online, we want to distribute 5 milliliters per seam of bees. A seam is the crack between two frames. We will use 5 milliliters per seam, but no more than 50 milliliters total per hive colony. Note that your honeybees may be more aggressive than normal. They are all in the hive at this point because it's cold, and they are very protective of their resources, so be sure to suit up. This dribble can be performed when you have a day that is at least 45 degrees Fahrenheit. Any lower and the bees will have a hard time keeping warm, even within their winter cluster. Work quickly, dribbling the acid solution through each seam over through the cluster.
They're becoming immobile because bees can't move well around 50 degrees. So one by one, I'm going to put them back. Come on. Mad at me.
And that's it. This is a last attempt to treat your bees for varroa mites before we go into the long winter season. Thanks so much for watching. You can find this recipe and also a sugar cake recipe for overwintering your bees on our website at axeandroothomestead.com.